about Tua and Simmons. But first, we have breaking news.
All the smart.
Rico?
Mike, we're
you received information about the job at LSU. And I think you should report it.
It is not breaking news. It is.
Hold on. What? Okay. According to Rico Beard sources, breaking news.
Yeah. Billy Napier, the
head coach at ULL.
ULL, Louisiana, is, looks to be the guy in the driver's seat. But nothing's going to get announced till the end of the year.
Rico, slow rolling it. His sources indicate the money's already been negotiated and it'll be announced after Thanksgiving. Breaking news, you can use 97.1. So, there you go. No, that's true or false. You made a series of phone calls and procured what you believe to be credible information about the coaching search at LSU. True or false? They are sources. True or false?
Yes.
Why? You know what? This is this man's problem. He's so beautiful and he's so scared to admit it. Just say, I did the work. We're putting the Tucker stuff to bed. Boom. Because, Mike, I've done this. This kind of reminds me of recruiting. Until they sign that name, I don't buy what 90, I don't buy 100% what any recruit tells me.
Okay.
So when it comes to coaching searches, that slam dunk guy, all of a sudden in the last, you know, Luke Fickell decided at the last second, all right, now Stannis says, Tuck ain't leaving. Here was the other
I'm looking at.
You gotta get Ben Simmons. Yeah, you gotta keep your nephew from driving the vehicle. Now, if I may, there is a preview, and I haven't seen it anywhere else, but it's on DraftKings. A spread for Michigan and Michigan State. Now, mind you, this is an advanced line. Can't take it as gospel. Michigan could go out and great, it could change. Michigan could have an injury. It could change. But if I said to you right now, what is the line for Michigan at Michigan State, October 30th, Spartan Stadium? If you had to guess, what would you guess?
I would guess Michigan minus 5.5.
5.5. David, noted Wolverine scumbag and pastor.
Michigan minus 3.5.
3.5, 5.5. What about Kenny? He hates both teams. He thinks he's better than both teams.
Oh, he does.
He says Michigan minus 1.
Okay. 1, 3.5, 5.5. Kenny's the closest. Michigan minus 2. A 2-point road favorite. Very interesting.
So is that one of those, it looks strange, or is that on par?
I thought the number.
Is that true when it comes to
here? I will just give you my read on this. Because of the size of Michigan's fan base, their lines are often loaded. And no team is worse than Michigan at covering said line. Vegas gets rich on people who bet on U of M.
They've covered this year.
No, I'm saying in the last 20 years. So you have to be careful. They don't put the line out for fun, and they don't put the line out as predictive measure. They put the line out of how do we get this money as close to 50-50. I am surprised that the line wasn't north of 50. I am.
Yeah, 4.5.
Now, here's what you'll have to watch. If this number holds and they release a 2 for next week, does that number go out to 2.5? Does it hit the key number of 3? Because my guess is if it ended up Michigan minus 3.5 or something, you'd see a buyback from people of, okay, home dog getting 3.5, come on. Then you start doing the research about Michigan in Spartan Stadium against a good Spartan team. They never beat us. Go look at history.
Aha! Jim Harbaugh's never lost.
Right, but those
twice
are,
as a coach.
Those are
twice
two of the worst Spartan teams of the last 20 years of my life.
I'm just saying that.
Aha!
Yeah!
He's never lost in Spartan Stadium. But it only rained on our side of the field. So
also, like, again, we've kind of talked about this. I don't believe in your passing. You need to see it to believe it. Well, Cade McNamara has 5 touchdowns. It's Halloween.
Yeah, the problem is, and we'll probably talk about this more tomorrow, I don't think you're going to see much of the passing game.
No.
Because Northwestern has a horrible run defense.
No.
If you're Michigan, you're just going to go in there.
That's their MO this year. We'll run it 60 times and get on to the next one.
Right.
What they're doing is hand to mouth. They're basically just, I see a crumb on the floor, let me pick it up and eat it. I just have not liked what Harbaugh has done as far as the long-term growth of the program. And if you have this electric quarterback that's going to be your future and going to beat OSU and going to be a 3-year starter, then you needed to do things a little bit differently. But hey, if running it 60 times and beating a deadbeat Northwestern team is what you want to do, do it. What am I going to say? I don't care. I don't like you.
That's what I see happening. And I know some people will say, well, they don't want to give Michigan State any tape, but they got to stop.
Every team's going to have a few things they haven't shown. It's in their back pocket for a rivalry game. I bet you Harbaugh's got a McCarthy package where he's going to throw the ball.
Right.
I bet you dollars to donuts, if you told me over-under on McCarthy passes against MSU, 1.5, I'll bet the over. And if MSU doesn't know it, and Scotty Hazleton doesn't know it, then they're brain dead. But my point is, nobody's hiding these vast expanses of their playbook. Nobody.
Right,
it's not real.
Right, like the touchdown to Tyler Hunt. That looked like a new play that they rolled out.
The other thing you do, you have wrinkles, right? You adapt things within the season. You have your formations, you have your personnel groupings, and then you have your concepts. You begin to add wrinkles to 1, 2, or all 3 of those things. But this idea that it's Madden, and I have these fun pages of the playbook. Okay, fine, you have a trick play. Everyone's got a trick play. I mean, hell, MSU runs a flea flicker every week. But it's like, fans are just, they drive me insane. The idea that you will tank 7 weeks of your season and your development, because we're saving it for our non-rival who we don't respect. What? No. I mean, it's just the truth.
It is. It is, but.
Like, MSU's not saving a bunch of stuff. They do what they are running their offense.
I'm
and
shocked.
Then you will adapt and you will add wrinkles to the groupings or the sequencing of it. Everybody has the same data. Hey, it's 2nd and long. This is the personnel grouping. This is the formation. This is their tendency. And then it's your job to self-scout and counter against it. But again, Jesus, no. Coaches don't spend all effing day whiteboarding stuff and going, zabbity-doo, we got 18 new plays. Like, it's just, you know what I'm saying? Like, you work all year for your players to have an even borderline working knowledge of what it is we do. Like, hey, you're a wide receiver and you go to the line, your job is to read the defense, know the route adjustment, maybe there's a check with me, maybe there's a sight adjustment. They're not putting plays down in the grass and, hey, Keon, you're this rock, and hey, Tyler, you're this pencil. Go 5 yards and turn around. Christ almighty.
I was just as shocked when I saw that Cade had only thrown 5 touchdowns.
Because they haven't prioritized the true development of a high-end passing. And if they think they can get through, look, this will be one of the more surprising things. If they can get through this gauntlet with a very mediocre passing, and that's what it is. I mean, you can take all the sizzle time when you're up by 40. I don't really care what you do then. None of that matters. Like, McCarthy throwing a 68-yard touchdown when you're up by 50, hey, it was a pretty ball. It's a ball. It was inadvisable to throw it, but he threw it. God bless. Did it again against Wisconsin, up by 30. It doesn't matter to me. I want to see the passing game be the reason. Be the reason that you're dominating. Like, I just, like the Washington game, guys, let me tell you something. I said it then, and I say it now. Washington gave up 250 against you. They gave up 250 against Oregon State. They gave up 250 again against UCLA. I'm sensing a trend that Washington can't stop nobody on the ground. You didn't bother to test a decent secondary, to test how your quarterback could handle those things. And
Nevertheless, when you went on the road against Nebraska, I thought Cade had a shakiest game. That didn't mean he was non-functional, but I didn't instill a ton of confidence in me. And then you bring McCarthy in and only let him run. I don't like it.
Well, I think
you should be letting McCarthy throw the ball a little bit.
I think for this game, you're going to see them run the ball, try to get up, and then sit everybody down. Especially for me, Hutchinson and Dax Hill, not going to play the second half because I don't even want you guys to get a targeting call so that you have to miss the first half of the MSU game. I'm benching those guys. I told David at the pre-show meeting, if I'm the trainer, I'm taking their helmets. You're not in the game in the second half.
And I got to say, this targeting thing, they got to fix it. It's not only the way it's called. They got to stop suspending kids for a half of the next week. I have a major issue with it because they never allow subjectivity with regards to intent.
You can't even appeal it. That's just it. Like, Cal Halliday, they tried to, and they're like, guys,
right. You're
right. I mean, MSU was told, basically, you're right, shouldn't have been called, but it was a judgment call.
I want both teams full strength.
It's arguing balls and strikes in baseball.
We're so close to this game now, I don't want no excuses. I want both teams full strength. Yes, I want Drew Beasley back for the game. He's one of our best defensive linemen. But, like, yeah, bring Dax, bring Hutchinson, bring the weightlifting gear, bring the highlight video. Just let's do it all. Let's just do this damn thing. Because I've dealt with you hyenas long enough that if, God forbid, one player gets hurt, you'll act like you're the only team who ever dealt with an injury. And then somehow I got to listen to you again. So let's just do the damn thing.
I'm with you, man. But this is where, you know, I think that you're going to probably see them run the ball because Northwestern can't stop it.
You see that spread?
Yeah,
it's 23.5.
It's still rising.
And I'd still take Michigan.
Mike, it may hit 25.5.
Good heavens. God almighty, that's crazy. But then again, Michigan against, when they're a big favorite, they generally just destroy.
But here's the funny thing.
They just don't win the big game.
5 out of 7 times they played Northwestern. One touchdown game. 2 overtime games.
No way. There's no way this thing. No way.
Just saying. They played an overtime and a triple overtime. Let's ask David. David probably knows.
Great time to pursue a tax settlement. Abraham and Rose, growing number of Americans have trouble paying their taxes or getting out of IRS debt. They call Jerry Maurice, the tax expert. You can't call a CPA. You need real tax attorneys here. Let them get between you and the IRS, sort it out, and get you the best settlement possible. Get out of your tax debt right now. It's Abraham and Rose. You need tax attorneys. You need Abraham and Rose. Call them today, 248-539-5040. That's 248-539-5040. Or you simply go to abrahamandrose.com.
Tonight, a CNN exclusive. At a critical moment in his presidency, Joe Biden takes questions from the American people. Anderson Cooper moderates a CNN presidential town hall tonight at 8 on CNN.
Whether it's after a hard day of work or relaxing on the weekend, we all love kicking back and watching live sports. And it doesn't matter what sport you're watching, it's always fun to have a little action. I don't care if it's baseball, football, basketball, hockey, auto racing, or golf. It's just more exciting when you're part of the game. That's why I downloaded the WynnBET app. That's WynnBET. Whether you're a recreational player like me or a serious handicapper, WynnBET is your ticket to every exciting wager. You've got straight bets, parlays, teasers, or any exotic proposition wager you can dream up. The app is easy to use, and everyone knows WynnBET is one of the biggest and best brands in the gaming industry. I know there are a lot of betting apps out there, so I got to go with one I trust. That's WynnBET. So get off the sidelines. Get the app on Google Play or Apple Store today. Put yourself in the game. Win with WynnBET. Must be 20.